Today, I'm going to share how to make alkaline bread. That's right, I'm sharing my easy and delicious alkaline bread recipe using alkaline ingredients exclusively from the Dr. Sebi food list. Stick around. Hey, I'm Tamatha Lene, indie artist, health enthusiast, and a mom. And on this channel, I share me and my family's journey to better health via detox, alkaline eating, and herbs. So if you want to learn more about alkaline living and how you can detox to support your body while it heals, make sure to subscribe and hit the notifications bell. I post new videos every week.
To make our spelt bread, it's really quick and easy. These are the ingredients you'll need. Grapeseed oil, basil, I like to use organic, onion powder, and Celtic salt is a really high quality salt that I like to use, oregano, organic again, cayenne pepper, and then you can use either spring water or Perrier mineral water. I've noticed that when you make it with the spring water, it's good, but when you use the sparkling water, it actually makes it a little softer and even fluffier. So I've just started using this, but for the first couple years when I would make this bread, I would just use spring water and it turned out really good as well. And then the final most important ingredient is this spelt flour. I use the sprouted spelt flour. Sprouted grains are so much easier for our bodies to digest than unsprouted grains, so that's why we use sprouted spelt flour. And all of these ingredients are on Dr. Sebi's recommended list, so this would be an alkaline spelt bread that doesn't create a lot of mucus in the body. But I also would say and mention this would not be considered a detox food. You want to detox aggressively, having any type of a grain would really slow your detox down. So this would be more of a food that you would eat while you were on a maintenance plan or while you were on a plan to transition into a detox. But these are the ingredients that you'll need for this alkaline Sebi inspired flatbread. We're going to add in our dry ingredients, and I'm going to start with this sprouted spelt flour.
Excuse me for a minute, y'all. Please click the like button and give this video a thumbs up if you are as excited about this alkaline spelt bread as I am. When you like the video, it really helps the channel, so thank you in advance.
We need 2 cups of sprouted spelt flour. We'll also be using a little more spelt flour later when we actually start to roll it out and we start to knead the bread and just kind of work the bread for about 5 minutes. So we'll also be using spelt flour then, and also to powder our surface. So we have 2 cups of spelt flour, and then I've already pre-measured out 2 teaspoons oregano, 2 teaspoons onion powder, and 2 teaspoons basil, already all measured out. And I'm just gonna dump that into our 2 cups of spelt flour. And then we also already have measured out 1.5 teaspoons of Celtic salt and a little less than 1/4 teaspoon of cayenne pepper. You don't have to use that much cayenne pepper. You don't have to use it at all if you don't like things spicy. But I like it a little spicy, but I also give this to my little 2-year-old daughter, so I don't put that much cayenne pepper in this. She loves this bread. We call it Sebi bread, so she'd be like, Sebi bread. And then you just want to mix all of our dry ingredients together. We just want to get this flour nice and seasoned. And I just use a fork to do this. Now that we've added all of our dry ingredients, got them all mixed together, now we can add our wet ingredients. So I will add now this Perrier water, 3/4 cup, and then also 2 tablespoons of grapeseed oil. So what I like to do, I'm gonna move this out the way. I like to actually mix them together so that I don't add them to the flour and the dry mixture separately. I like to pre-mix these. I'll go ahead and measure into this cup measure here, 3/4 cup. Listen to that. And then this is a 2 tablespoon measure. I'm just gonna add 2 tablespoons of grapeseed oil. Go ahead and mix that in. And we know what they say, that oil and water don't mix, but we gonna make them mix. Just kind of mix them together. And then once you kind of got those as mixed as they will be, now we'll slowly start to add this. Don't add it all in one big pour. Just slowly add this mixture to your dry ingredients. Just kind of really make sure that it gets worked in there. Eventually, what our goal is to get this worked into a ball. You see some little dry areas, try to pour the water and the oil there. a minute. There's still some more, but let's just take a minute and mix that a little more. All right, and let's add in our last little more stir here. Add in our last little section. You see, I'm just trying to get all the sides, get it all. Now, once you've got that, you want to just set your timer for 5 minutes. And knead this bread, which is just work it through, fold it over. You just want to knead it for 5 minutes. And if it's kind of sticky, then all you need to do is add a little more. You can just sprinkle a little more flour on it. But this is actually a really good texture right now. This recipe, I love it because it's so quick. It really doesn't take much time at all. From start to finish, you can pretty much be done with it in like 30 minutes. That's from measuring ingredients, kneading it for 5 minutes, rolling it out, and putting it on the skillet and cooking it. It's really, really a great, fun, simple recipe that the whole family will love. I know, like I said, my two-year-old absolutely loves it. I love it. I use it for pizza. I use it for sandwiches. I use it just as a side dish for like salads, just nice bread. You can do it for avocado toast. And now that we have my delicious alkaline sea moss cheese recipe, you can do so much with the cheese and this bread. You know, put the cheese on top of the bread just for like a nice little grilled cheese sandwich. Make sure to stay tuned for my alkaline macaroni and cheese recipe. There's a really great spelt macaroni. I'll insert a picture here. There's a really, really good, I think it's Nature's Legacy is the brand. They make really good spelt pasta. I have a really fun macaroni and cheese recipe using the alkaline sea moss cheese recipe. So definitely stay tuned for that macaroni and cheese recipe coming up. And the next recipe that I'll be posting will be this, actually using this spelt bread and my sea moss cheese to make a really fun gourmet grilled cheese sandwich. So we'll just knead this for only about 2.5 minutes left. We'll just speed through that with the magic of video. And next time I see you, or next time you see me, we'll be rolling out this bread. Okay, so our bread is all kneaded and nice and perfect texture. And so now we're ready to actually roll out our bread and get it ready to cook. Clean your surface down. I like to roll this out directly on my counter, so you just want to make sure that's really nice and clean. I add a little flour to the counter. And then section your bread off into 4 pieces or 6 pieces. It just depends on how big you want to make your pieces. I like to make mine pretty big. You could make one big piece. You could use it for dough, pizza dough. If I use it for pizza dough, I usually double the recipe, and then I can make one rectangular cookie sheet pan. Use that for my crust. This is a really good crust. Move these out the way, and we'll go ahead and roll out our bread. And it's just kind of oval shape. The key is not to roll it too flat. You want it to have a little bit of a thickness, just a tad, so that it's not cracker crust thin. So it has a little nice doughiness to it. So that's about how thin I make mine. And while you're rolling out your pieces, you can go ahead and turn the fire on under your pan so it can be preheating. Put it on a medium heat. What I like to do is once I have one rolled out, I go ahead and put it on the pan and let it cook while I roll out the others. So this one's pretty big. I did this one pretty long and narrow. So I can only fit 2 on at a time for that, because that one's so big. And you'll see that you don't need to oil the pan. I made the mistake at first of oiling the pan, and it actually made it more messy to cook it, and it'll be sticking. But it doesn't stick when you just leave it like as is and don't put any oil. Even if you're using a regular skillet that's not cast iron, I've noticed that it doesn't stick in either skillet. You don't need oil. So you just want to keep it on each side for just a few minutes. If your pan is already hot probably just like a minute and a half, 2 minutes for the first side. It really browns and cooks pretty fast because the bread is so thin. So you just want to keep an eye on it and have your spatula handy so that you can just look at it and just check and make sure that it's not overcooking. And you just want to cook it slow, just medium. Don't have the fire too high. So now we will check it and flip it. Yeah, it seems ready to be flipped. Yeah, so you see it has a nice little brown to it, and we can flip it back over if we need to, but it has a nice little brown, and it still has a nice little thickness. I don't know if you can see, just it's really nice. Check this one here. Yeah. Looking good. And there's some space now for the little piece. I made a little piece for my daughter. Go ahead and put that in the center there. You see why I like to use this type of a pan if possible, just because you can get more on there at once. And see, look, it's almost, it's pretty, you could really stop there. So we'll come to our cooling rack and add our bread. It's only about a 30-minute process from start to finish. It's really fast. So here they all are. All shapes and sizes, a little mini one for my little two-year-old. And so now I'll be using this same bread to make alkaline CMOS cheese, grilled cheese sandwiches. So definitely subscribe, stay tuned so you do not miss that video coming up next.
Make sure you go to my website and subscribe to my newsletter so you don't miss the announcement for my upcoming alkaline recipe book and detox transition guide. I've been talking with y'all and listening to what you need, and I'm creating this recipe book and detox transition guide to set you up for success and help those of you looking to transition yourselves and your families into an alkaline lifestyle. To subscribe to the newsletter, all you have to do is go to my website, tamathalene.com, which is linked below, and scroll down and the subscribe prompt will pop up into your email, and voila, you are subscribed. If you want to learn more about alkaline living and detox, watch my series, Detox Made Easy, and my complete Dr. Sebi playlist. And go and binge watch the previous videos in my All Things CMOS series, like how I healed my acne scars with CMOS, and how to tell real from fake CMOS, and how to make you and your kids some CMOS popsicles. Join my Facebook group, Alkaline Living and Detox, for more meal plan ideas, Q&A, and a community of like-minded individuals. Please do subscribe, like, and share this video if it was helpful for you and you feel like it could help others. I am Tamatha Lene. Thank you so much for watching. Take care, God bless, and I will see you in the next video.